Hi, myself, I'm Ratna Bhushan. Welcome to this program, Superior Uplifting Management. Before starting the program, I would like to read the preamble of our constitution. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of individual and the unity and integrity of the nation, in our constituent assembly this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. So today's most important topic is, yesterday I read about the speaking tree, which is a beautiful article related to the Gautam Buddha, and today is our day of the Girl Child Progress Report. India has moved forward in empowering girls, but it still lacks much of the world. So it's related to the women power, the lacks of the girls power. Today is International Day. Today is it is 11th of October 2017. So a good day, I celebrate the progress India has made in advance rights of the half of its children. Concerted efforts over the last decades are bringing results. According to the National Family and Health Survey 2015-16, teenager pregnancy has halved in the last 10 years, and percentage of the girls married as children had decreased from 47% to 27%. 47% to 27%. 47% to 20%. So the Indian Constitution provides a powerful mandate for human rights in the preamble, fundamental rights and duties, and specific provisions for affirmative actions. The government has instituted laws and policies protecting the rights of the girls and women, including a ban on dowry, pre-birth sex determination and child marriages. State schemes and program provide bicycles, hostels like skills and stipend. Nationally, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao directly tackle the birth rate sex determination, and along with the Sabla and Sukanya. So these are the some programs which were started by our government. A girl cannot be educated and learn skills if she cannot be freely, safely and access school, college, health clinics, sports, market and workplace. India is also home to robust social movements and organizations for gender equality and women's rights. A few of us can forget the months after December 2012, when one of the largest protests on violence against the women and girls resulted in the Indian Parliament amending within the months of the Section 375 of the Indian Penal Code. This now includes largely progressive elements on preventing and responding on the violence against women and girls, stories and images of the girls boys fighting, gender-based discriminations and violence of film, newspaper every day in every language. So there is one quote said in Manusmriti, where the women are not going to be respected, the God do not survive. Indian girls are more likely to be anemic than Indian boys, but also fare worse than the global average of anemia. 167 out of 1 lakh Indian girls or women die giving birth, compared to a developed country average of 14. Indian girls are more likely to be married or children than boys, are more likely to be sexually abused and trafficked. So these are the most important topic of today's. Thank you very much. If you like, subscribe and all. Mera video dekhne ke liye dhanyavaad. Agar aapko acha lagta hai, to please share kare, subscribe kare and like kare. Thank you so much. All the best.